little side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. McLean is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started.
Hirsch takes it to 15. Brought down at the 30.
Kirk, one of the top backs in the country we get a chance to see today. Bates' big play ability makes him a threat to score really anytime he touches it.
I love this guy. And let's not forget about his big offensive line. This is a group that really prides themselves in opening up some huge holes for him. It's also going to be difficult to stop him and keep him out of the end zone because, you think about it, he's known for his big plays, the home run ability. So if you can limit those big plays, you got a shot at least at slowing him down.
And he gets the ball 25, 30 times a game, and he'll probably get that again today.
Second and six. Ball on the 34.
He's got it out to his tight end. And they make the stop right around the 36-yard line.
He didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
Strong showing by the defense. You always like to get the other team's offense off the field as fast as you can.
Washington is back deep to return the punt.
And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
Blackburn on the delay.
Up the middle for a nice game. It's second down, five to go.
Ball on their own 43.
He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
Hirsch, the return man.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency.
Bates on the run, and they get him in the backfield for a loss.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
From their own 27-yard line, second down. Quick toss. And he snags that one. And he's tackled right away.
Great play for the offense and a great call by the offense. But the defense has to change things up. They've got to put more pressure on this quarterback.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 44. The middle. That's a
that makes it second and six.
Man left, man left. Two down. Ready.
just throws this one away. Third down now. They need to get it down to the 34. Receiver's got the first down, and he's taken down around the 32-yard line.
That is just sound, fundamental football right there, making it look so easy.
And he's tackled at the 32-yard line. We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 32.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
Here's the eighth play of the series. He's in trouble. This one's going deep to the end zone. Oh, what an interception.
It looked like the pass was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular interception.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 20. He's met immediately. That's a loss of about five.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
From their own 15-yard line, second down. He's tackled at about the 25-yard line. Caught with room to work. He's going to come up shy of the first down marker, guys.
Had that not been a great defensive effort, he would have easily gotten there.
Hirsch is the deep man awaiting the return. Hirsch fields it at the 38. And down he goes at the 47-yard line. Boy, this is just a defensive battle so far, Kirk.
Well, it's a combination of a couple things, Brad. I think the defenses are playing well, but I think the offenses at this point are making it a little bit easier for them. So let's see if these offenses can get it going a little bit to try to challenge these defenses.
And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. Second and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. So at the end of one, this one's scoreless. Welcome back to the action. Just about set to start quarter number two, and we're all tied up. They come out in a five-wide set. Down at the 36-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
From the 36-yard line, it's first down. Gets it quickly to the tight end, but it's dropped. yards here. Loss of about two.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
They'll line it up again on third down. Under heavy pressure. And they got him.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. And it seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game. He was able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Made around the 15-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. He's taken down at about the 15-yard line.
It's a nice run here by the offense to be able to pick up this first down. It's very important to maintain possession of that football, and that's a nice conversion here on third down.
Fakes to the back. He's going to air it long. No, incomplete. From their own 17-yard line, it's second down. Screen pass. He's knocked out of bounds around the 26-yard line. He gets out to about the 37-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 37-yard line. Makes it, and the quarterback scrambles. And down he goes, the 37-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Tackle at the 48-yard line. This has been a very steady drive so far. It's first and 10, and we're right around midfield. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. This is the 10th play of this drive. Complete. He's got room. And they make the stop at the 28. First and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's taken down at the 16-yard line. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Handoff, and he's met in the backfield. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed him.
From the 19-yard line, second down. Pitch out, got the corner, And he gets a yard on the run.
That's the senior safety that made that tackle. Great job of providing run support from the secondary.
And here's the 14th play of the drive. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. And he's tackled around the 7-yard line. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete. And they lose possession on down.
You know, that was one of those situations where you have to go for it to try to get something going. Now they need a big play here from their defense.
Really a great stop by the defense. This will go down as one of those critical plays. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Tackled after a decent pickup. That's a deep ball. That makes it second and six. It's second and six. Ball on the 11. So we've played two quarters. Still no score.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw. Both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they've tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickeration?
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run some reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
And the second half just about set to get started. We're dead even. James from the three. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Maxwell gets about a yard on the play. It's second and 10. Ball on their own 27. From their own 48-yard line, first down. He's into the open field. He's at the 40. Makes it out to about the 39. his way to about the 28. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 28. This to try to put his team up by a field goal. Kicks up, and it splits the uprights. McLean has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 31. You know, sometimes you see defenses play good in stretches. This has been the longest stretch I've seen one defense play in a football game in a long time.
Yeah, I think the consistency is the thing that stands out. I think they got off to a great start. At halftime, they made a few adjustments, and they've come out and even played better, believe it or not, here in this second half.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Steps out of bounds at the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's a D5 on the play. That'll bring up third and inches.
First and 10, ball on the 47. Nice run there. Bates gains about 5 yards on the run.
That brings him second and 5.
Rid of this one. And here's another third down. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's tackled at the 36. His way to the 26-yard line. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy.
That brings him second and one.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Little handoff. He tackles him for a loss.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. They can get some protection. They might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. He fights forward to about the 26. They come out on an empty backfield. Tries to buy some time. Slides down. So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
He gets to about the 5.
second and one.
We're at the 12th play of the drive.
Man left, man left. Three down, three down. Watch 14.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. They don't get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper. A loss of one. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Brought down at the three. And this is the 14th play of the drive. Great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. The score here at Amon G. Carter Stadium is the Rangers 3, the Cougars nothing. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. He's got the corner. Touchdown, and now they're in front. That score puts them in the driver's seat right now offensively. The question is, can the defense hold on here in the fourth quarter? And he converts the extra point. A 14-play, 68-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. So our score, 7-3. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 22-yard line. Well, the defenses have certainly been the story of this one.
The defenses are playing great. I might recommend dropping down a level or two. Instead of playing at the higher level, go down to the freshman level and give yourself a chance to execute a little bit better.
Early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight football game, and the game could hinge on this possession. Fires quickly to the tight end. He steps out right around the 24-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. Made at about the 27-yard line. Fires that quickly to the tailback. He's taken down at the 31-yard line. Is back deep to return. Tackle made at the 34. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. It out to about the 37-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Clipping. Offense.
Clipping is the call, and now they'll have to find a way to make up those yards right here. It's first down and a lot. The 17-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes, around the 24-yard line. Third down and a couple of miles here.
Ball on the 24. Here comes the pressure, going deep. Makes the catch, and look out. And he's finally shoved out at the 30. What a play.
What a play is right. Here they throw the ball to the tight end, and the big guy shows that he's valuable not only as a blocker, but as a receiver as well. Nice catch.
Just under three to go in regulation. Gets it off as he's hit. Complete. Still on his feet. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. First and goal from the four. They're knocking on the door.
Well, the running back always wants to try to hide. It almost is being a decoy. I'm just in here to block. I'm picking up the blitz, and then at the last second, he just kind of slips out behind those linemen. In many cases, the defenders, the linebackers and safeties who are trying to come up to make a play, they can't even see the running back because he's behind those big 100, 300-pound offensive linemen.
And he gets the touchdown. Bates' play showing why he's a humble kid, and I'm sure he's going to give the credit to his offensive line.
Yeah, Brad, nothing is more gratifying to me watching a game like this unfold than a superstar player like this going straight to his offensive linemen and giving them the credit for that touchdown. What a class act.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. James from the 2. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Looks middle. Got his back. And they make the stop around the 25-yard line. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And he stops the clock with a spike. From their own 25-yard line, third down. Here's the throw. I don't think he got anything on that. Here's the screen to the wideout. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And they push him out around the 47-yard line. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
From their own 47-yard line, first down. Quick strike to the receiver. He's pushed out of bounds around the 43-yard line. Forward to about the 40. That makes it second and eight. The spike will stop the clock. It's the ninth play of the drive. Oh, here we go.
zips it to the tailback, incomplete. And again, they're going for it on fourth down. We have less than a minute to go. So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win. This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. Third down now, and they need to get it out to midfield. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, 14-3, Cougars. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.